Callander Bay is a bay at the extreme east of Lake Nipissing in the municipality of Callander, Parry Sound District, Ontario, Canada. It is approximately 4 kilometers in diameter, and the community of Callander is located on the east side. Lake Nipissing is a lake in the Canadian province of Ontario. It has a surface area of 337 square miles, a mean elevation of 643 feet above sea level, and is located between the Ottawa River and Georgian Bay. Lake Nipissing is the third largest lake entity in Ontario. It is relatively shallow for a large lake with an average depth of only 15 feet. The shallowness of the lake makes for many sandbars along the lake's irregular shoreline. Lake Nipissing reaches a maximum depth of 210 feet near the mouth of the French River off the shore of Blueberry Island. The lake has many islands, most of which are protected under the Protection of Significant Wetlands Scheme, controlled by the Ministry of Natural Resources and Forestry. This week, we're visiting Sunbeam Bungalows on Callander Bay, fishing for walleye with our good friend and local guide, Josh McKay. Vertical jigging the shoals and reefs with ball head jigs and live bait, such as night crawlers and minnows. Okay, one of the greatest things about fishing Lake Nipissing is it's only about 3.5 hours north of the GTA, right off Highway 11, and there's so many opportunities for so many species, man. Four seasons of the year. The ice fishing is incredible for walleye, pike, big perch, but we're after the walleyes. And me and Joshy Boy are gonna go out some of his favorite shoals, put on the ball head jigs, either, you know, put on a night crawler or a minnow, and just get out there, pull our hats down, have a good time, because this big lake north of the city has provided so many good adventures for so many people over the years. And you know why it's so much fun? Because they keep coming back year after year, because they never let them down. Excellent fishing, proximity to the closer to highways and things like that. So it's just drive to locations, as well as the fantastic accommodations and the lodge operators that surround this big, beautiful lake.
Man, this is a bass again for sure. Yeah, see?
Oh my goodness. You know what? They're just off bottom and that's what they're eating, that drop shot, eh?
They're just crushing it.
Yeah. You put them right in front of their face. And I'm on the bottom, and guess what?
Perfect. You're catching the walleyes.
But how many different species in one spot? Oh, look at that. It's getting up. Whoa, spit the worm at me. There's
right
a
there.
14 plus, eh?
Yeah.
Whoa. But that is the bread. Whoa, you got me again. Those fins, they are deadly little buggers, aren't they?
Oh, the gill plates and stuff are ruthless. But
the bread and butter fish of Ontario, man. It really, really is. I tell ya. You Americans that are watching the shows right now, I tell you, boy, so many opportunities for these across Northeast Ontario where we are, Algoma, the Northwest, Superior, you name it, man. It's walleye heaven. Everywhere you go, different opportunities, different lodges, fly-ins, everything. But you just got to get here. All right. New worm, new opportunity. Yeah, all we're doing is just get to the bottom. Okay, quarter ounce jigs, and once you feel the bottom, the line goes slack, okay? And I just shake it real lightly, just shake it real light. And then just drop it to the bottom again, get a little bit of slack in your line, bring it back up again. So I'm as close to the bottom as I want. Josh has seen these fish with their nose and belly on the bottom. So I want to keep that bait right in front of their nose. All they got to do is pull it in. So far, so good.
Fish.
Good one?
Not pretty good here yet.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, this is what you want, Carl.
Okay. Oh, let's see where I'm at.
There he is, gold bar.
Oh, yeah. Come here, boy. Oh, nice one. Nice one. Ooh.
Nice nip keeper, boys.
Yeah, man. You said it too, eh?
Onto the juice we go.
Yeah, man. That's an 18 for sure, plus.
We nailed it, baby.
Yeah, man.
Here we go.
Okay. First official fish in the net. Look at that. Wow.
And the drop shot fell out.
Yeah, man. Good stuff. He was on the back side of this, Josh?
Yeah, okay. About 18 feet of water.
Okay.
See that, we're fishing 32. Well,
yeah.
69 degree water temp. And I mean, I'll come off this for a second. And if you look at the bottom, it's hard to see it right now, but they're stacked in there like cordwood.
Okay.
22 right there. We'll put this guy in the well.
Okay.
Have a nice little snack.
So it's a fine mix of not using a jig too heavy so they can suck it in, and not too light where you got a lot of bow and you're chasing, the boat moves and you're getting snagged up on rocks and things where the walleyes are hanging around. Try to keep it as vertical as possible, depending on the weight, the wind, the depth you're fishing. But right now, that quarter ounce is perfect. Putting it right in front of her. Oh my God, dude. Oh, the electricity through their braid is scary. That. Sunbeam Bungalows is ideally located in a sheltered bay of Lake Nipissing, on the outskirts of the small town of Callander near North Bay, easily accessible by a 3.5-hour scenic highway drive from Toronto. The resort is open year-round, with the main season being mid-May to mid-October, and offers midweek, weekend, and weekly packages in a range of cottages, 1, 2, and 3 bedroom, which are ideal for individuals, couples, families, or groups of friends. Check out the other pages on their website for detailed information about what interests you. Another reason why I like to fish walleye on Lake Nipissing, it's just somewhat easy, really easy. These right here, you know what those are? Ball head jigs. But it's just those reefs. The walleyes are on their reefs from season opening to season closing. Sometime of the day, no matter where you go, first light to the evening and afternoon, you're gonna find walleyes on Lake Nipissing. By putting down the jig, pulling down your hat, focusing, make sure that jig's on bottom, and sooner or later it's gonna be tick, walleye.
Oh, there it is. Back.
And that, maybe a couple pounds, will be my first Nipissing walleye. First, like that, if you had to eat, that's eat. But what's the rules here?
You gotta be 18.1 or bigger right now.
Okay, so healthy, look how beautiful those fish are, man. I'll give you that. Chunky too, eh? So that's 15 maybe, huh?
Yeah, about 15 inches.
And those are your custom hooks, eh?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Custom poured.
Custom jigs.
He actually made these the other night just for us right here. But Nipissing's got those regulations to keep the fishery as healthy as it is. And there it is.
Come on, that big juicy is just floating in your face. You know you want it.
Right there too, isn't it? Boy.
Yeah, like that.
Does he feel?
Nah. Coming right up like a little guy again. Nicer, nice, still nice 16.
Oh boy, yeah man. There's another one there too. I should just stand with the net. See these right here? That's the number one size jig we like to use on Nipissing. 5/16, made by Josh, Northern Tackle Supply. You know what? This is just the perfect size because you want a jig that you can just feel the bottom. You don't want it too heavy because sometimes you gotta go near rock and different things and you don't wanna be snagged up. It just bothersome. Break line, tie off, put another jig on. The 5/16 and quarters are perfect. If there's a little bit of chop, I would go definitely with the 5/16 and maybe the 3/8, but just keep it just off the bottom, okay? Takes a little bit finer touch just to keep that jig off the bottom. But you keep it as vertical as possible. Don't make those pitches out there. Try to fish right below your boat. Very important for walleyes on Nipissing. But the 5/16, quarter ounce, that's all you really need. Whoa, that might be another 15. I'm gonna say, if it's a perch, I got one of the Ontario records. No, it's one of those, just, look, it almost looks like a blue one. No, just gorgeous, man. Oof. Lake Nipissing, it's healthy, boy. Oof. He's spitting out minnows too. Woo! Healthy little walleyes. But it's 18 and a half, right?
18.1.
Okay.
Yeah, a bunch of us are hoping for a little bit of a rule change coming next year, we're hoping.
Okay.
Usually they implemented a 5-year plan for us out here.
And what are you looking at? Just a different size?
Yeah, smaller slot.
Yes.
So like 15 to like 17.
Oh God, eh? 15. Is it?
It's all right, but I don't know if he's gonna be a keeper, but he feels okay.
Let me know, because I could
Probably keepable.
Oh boy. This. Whoa, he's close.
Probably a real close one there, guys.
17.
That one might push 18-1.
Yeah. Right when we see them, eh? What was that, 20 feet behind us, right?
Yeah.
The fish?
I'll give a quick measurement here. Let's see what we got here. It might be close. See how close we are here with this one, guys? Look at that. Just about an 18. That there's 17 3/4. 17 3/4 and a bit.
Yep.
So.
Back he goes.
See you later, big guy. Have a nice day.
Lucky.
What do you got there?
Smaller fish. I'm just bringing up slow in that deeper water. Feels like maybe pickerelly. Let's see, what are you? Are you just pretending now? Oh, look at
not
that.
A bad one.
Look at that nice, beautiful Lake Nipissing walleye. I am so impressed. So I fight that fish a little bit slower in that deep water. You don't have to worry. Oh, he's fine.
Yeah.
Look at that. That's just fantastic, man. I mean, fantastic. Thick fish. Boy, oh boy, what a fishery. Ready, buddy, go back down. He has no idea we're even here. 30-something feet of water.
Sunbeam Bungalows started with the Bain family. The Bains had a vision for a family and fishing resort that would cater to people who love to fish, as well as offering an ideal holiday location for those who prefer to do other things. Their dream was to create a welcoming and friendly resort in a setting enhanced by the magnificent panorama and beautiful sunsets of Lake Nipissing, while always respecting the surrounding land, community, and wildlife. David and Diane Bain are pleased to see the vision continue with the next generation, their daughter Sarah, son-in-law Darren, and family, in the same way that it continued when they took over from David's parents back in 1977, when David's parents acquired the business back in 1942. This is truly a family commitment.
Oh, a little pickerelly. Little pickerelly. But look, right through the nose, eh? Oof. He's hanging around those big jumbo perch. But that's exactly what I mean about just making sure that bait is as vertical as you can, shaking it. But the biggest thing about the braid, it just cuts through the line so you can get to the bottom a lot quicker. And with that fluorocarbon leader, they don't see anything. So I get it down there, let it go, free fall, all the way. And as soon as I get a little bit of slack line, I know where I am. I'll pick up that slack and start jigging. Well, I'll get down there. There we are, on bottom. Tighten up a little bit. And I like to have, like I said, about 18 inches to 2 feet. So it's no waves hitting my rod tip or nothing. And just shaking up and down. There we go. And a little, it might be 16 plus. Gosh, it might be. Look.
Hey.
Hey.
That's a nice, look at how healthy they are, though.
I'd say, boy.
Man, like
this
a healthy
is where
fish.
I want every walleye that I ever catch.
Caught. Right in the roof of the mouth. Yeah.
Look at that. Right through.
The perfect placement.
And that's the bite that I like, too. The real distinct.
Yes.
Look how chunky the beautiful walleyes are. Hold on. I'll let you go. Beautiful Nipissing walleye. Man, talk about a healthy fishery. Oof. Thank you.
That right there I call four of a kind. 5/16 ball head jig, all by Northern Tox Supply, and the colors that catch walleye on Nipissing. A little bit of a chartreuse with white and blue. White with orange. Straight chartreuse and white. You can't go wrong with either a leech, nightcrawler or minnow on Nipissing. You put these down there near those shoals, reefs, bars, drop-offs, you name it. These are the jigs that provide the walleyes. Those colors right there. You'll always see either me or Josh having one of these colors on. When you got two guys in the boat, sometimes three, when you first start out, one guy try maybe minnows, another guy a leech, another guy a worm. Different color of jig until somebody starts producing either on the different size or the different color of jig, different bait, then you all can change. It's sometimes a mistake by all doing the exact same thing that worked last time on a different lake or Lake Nipissing. The way to find the walleye bite, because it changes too periodically from day to day, hour to hour, is have different color jigs tied on with different guys, or you have more than one rod in the boat with different bait, and you'll catch those Nipissing walleye just like us.
Here's some, Carl.
Good one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Taking a nit on them?
No, it's just your rod.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, gorgeous fish. That's getting close. That's about 17 plus, eh?
Come here, buddy.
That's getting close.
What a nice fish. Like you said, look even the bottom of the jaw, that one.
Yeah, man. Gorgeous wallers. Wow. I'm impressed at how healthy they look.
Yes.
But yeah, in a lot of places, northwest and stuff, it's, you know, you really protect that one slot size. I think there's a lot of those spawners that come through.
Yes.
And then you're only allowed one big one over, but no one really does anymore.
No, you don't need the big ones.
No. In a trophy fishery for a picture, yeah, man. Yeah. I'm all in. I love catching big fish. But for eating the walleyes, 16, 17.
I miss them so much out here eating those 16s and 17s out here.
Yep. Oh, you know. How's that feel?
Nothing right. Crazy. Better than the last one. He's acting better, actually. Nice fish, though.
Oh, my goodness. See, that would be perfect eaters right there.
Oh, the
those
best
are
ones.
Perfect.
Like you say, hook in the roof of the mouth, right?
Oh, my. Yeah. Perfect eaters.
Hey. Relax.
Nice. They're just helping to bring the fishery back, right, Josh?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, you can go out and take kids out and catch 100 of those in a day.
Yeah.
You know, the only bummer is not just telling the kids you got to send them all home. You got to go home. You got to put them back.
I teach them how to fish for walleye, right?
Yeah.
As soon as I touched bottom, I went to pick up that slack and there's already a bite there, fish there.
Yeah.
See?
Oh, that looks like a batter.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Need a net, anything?
You think I'm going to feel brave?
Nice little head shake on her, eh?
Yeah. She's almost there.
That's close. Right? That's close.
But it's not, you know. I can just tell it's not. It's like 17.
Yeah, you know, just for the heck of it, we'll let everybody see how we do that up here. We put the tapes on.
Those hooks.
Hi, my name is Darren Caruso. My wife Sarah and I own Sunbeam Bungalows Family and Fishing Resort. We have 13 fully house-kept deluxe cottages, ranging from 1-2 superior 2-bedroom and 3-bedrooms. The cottages come fully equipped. They all have nice decks with barbecues, picnic tables, and fire bowls. We also have lots of outside amenities. We have communal fire pits. We have gazebos with propane fire bowls that you can utilize anytime. There's communal barbecues for larger groups and many other sports activities like basketball, shuffleboard, outdoor ping pong table covered with a gazebo, badminton, lots of stuff for everybody to do of all ages. Lake Nipissing is world renowned for its walleye fishing, pickerel, pike, muskie, bass, small and largemouth. It's an excellent lake. The fisheries are great, very healthy. We have a fleet of 14 boats and motors, Legend Pro Sports with 25 and 30 horsepower electric start Mercuries, color depth finders, power trim, all the safety gear, of course, and lighting are provided. If you liked what you saw here at Sunbeam Bungalows, we would just love to have you and your family or your groups of friends. It's a wonderful place and I know you'll have an excellent time here.
That's the magic right there when sometimes those Nipissing walleyes have a soft bite. They're a little stinger hook on a little piece of fluorocarbon. Josh makes these up for us and they're obviously for sale on his website. Check them out on Facebook, Northern Tackle Supply. And they're so easy to attach to a ball head jig. There's the treble hook design and the single hook. We like to use the single hook one a lot and I'll show you how easy it is to put this on, okay? So you just slide the little loop over the hook point, grab onto the hook and just pull slow and now it's tight. And now what you got is a little 1-2 punch. Ball head jig, very sharp, stinger hook, you're gonna catch those walleyes.
Boom. How's
better
that one?
Fish, look at that.
That was a big head shake.
Whoa, is that walleye?
Likely.
If that's walleye, it's a good one. I think so, Josh. Oh yeah. Whoa. Oh, you know what? Because I haven't caught. Let's see.
That's it. Oh. That's going to be another close one, eh, boys?
Yeah, man. Easy, buddy, easy. Let's see. Okay. 17 on the button. But he's like 17, eh?
Oh, that might go this
right there. Huh? Whoa, he's gone. That's how we do it on Nipissing, eh?
Whether you come to fish or spend a family vacation here, the Caruso family, Darren, Sarah, and their five children, will look forward to welcoming you and your family and friends, old and new, to Sunbeam Bungalows Family and Fishing Resort on the shores of Callander Bay, Lake Nipissing. Call Sunbeam Bungalows to book your family vacation at 1-877-298-9998 or visit them online at www.sunbeambungalows.com.